Okay, fellas, be with you in a sec. Jeff, how long to go?
Yeah, you got a couple of minutes.
Okay, then a quick roll call. Tony?
Yeah.
Max?
Yeah, I'm here, Rich.
Rod?
Yeah.
Ian?
Yes, Rich, I'm here.
Bill?
Good evening, Richie. Good evening, all. Sorry I'm a bit late.
Not good enough, Bill. Okay, here's the story. We're going to kick it off with Bill and Tony again.
Oh, gee, fair sake.
Hey, now come on. Look, we all know that the Bill and Tony niggling aggro thing's working its ass off. The viewers love it. So come on, let's work as a team, please, and do it my way. Now, I'll decide who's going next a bit later on.
45 seconds, Richie.
Okay. All right, fellas. Well, it looks like it could be a bit of a one-sided affair out there tonight, so let's make sure we keep it up vibe and keep it interesting. All right, we'll have a good call, and I'll see you back here later during one of the ad breaks.
Yeah, okay.
See you later, Richie. See you later, all.
Welcome back to the Melbourne Cricket Ground for this vitally important one-day clash in the Benson and Hedges World Series Cup between Australia and Sri Lanka. A magnificent atmosphere around the ground here, beautiful sunny day today and a balmy evening this evening. A capacity crowd of 420,000 people in attendance, and they've been treated to an absolutely masterful display of skillful batting by the Australians. 3 for 560 after their 50 overs, a marvellous effort that. Easily the best I've seen from them this summer. And it was an innings played under extremely difficult conditions too. Just before the commencement of play this morning, Tony Gregg jammed another bunch of those fucking keys of his into the pitch, and once again he hasn't been able to get the fucking things out. This will be the fourth time I've had to drive him home this summer, and I can tell you I'm getting pretty pissed off. This bloody obsession Tony has for sticking things into the wicket is really getting quite out of hand. As a matter of fact, earlier this season he borrowed a magnificent gold and onyx fountain pen of mine, and to this day it remains buried some 6 or 8 inches somewhere under this fucking pitch. And now here today, we've seen the Australian batsman having to contend with Tony's buddy car keys sticking out of the turf just in front of the popping crease down at the members' end. And while this provided the Australians with a few anxious moments, it didn't stop them from putting on a superb batting performance for their 560 runs. Let's take a look at the Australian card now. And what a marvellous sight that is. Only the 5 batsmen needed, and all 5 scoring magnificent centuries. Mark Taylor, a brilliant knock from him of 118 before he was dismissed by a very good ball from the Sri Lankan pace bowler Sumjerk Ramakar, finding the outside edge, and in the end a pretty simple catch there for the keeper. Give us a hand, Lickerackney. Geoffrey Marsh struggled early, but eventually got his eye in and went on to make 103 before being trapped LBW off the bowling of Lone Rangers into silver. David Boone top scored for the Australians with a brilliant innings of 130 off just 55 balls. He played some glorious strokes here today, David Boone, smashing the Sri Lankan bowlers all over the ground, especially arriving to Hayakar and Labroy. They really copped some stick. And Boone eventually caught in the gully by Some I Can Tell You, Some Are a Secret, off the bowling of Labroy. Jones and Border, the not-out batsmen, a superb effort again from this pair to carry the Australian innings. Jones undefeated on 109, Border 102, and both men playing some magnificent strokes, as indeed did all of the Australian batsmen.